Luckily, we've come. So, am I turning as I say that? Or...
No, so it's if I'm you. Luckily, we've come a long way since then.
Got it? I feel like I could almost, like, wink at the end.
You can! Yeah. Whatever feels good. Yeah. Alright, let's run it.
My name is Jin-Sung Kim, but you can call me Jin for short, and I'm going to be your host for Coding with Qiskit this season. Last season, Abe did a really nice job of introducing the fundamentals of programming a quantum computer using Qiskit.
So let's get started.
That was good, but the screen turned off in the middle of it.
This season, we're going to do a deeper dive and learn how to program algorithms and applications using Qiskit. So I'm based out of the San Francisco Bay Area now, and I'm currently working on how to push the most performance out of quantum computers that exist today. I did my PhD in electrical engineering and material science at Princeton, and this is actually how I know Abe. We're actually lab mates together, so we go way back. Luckily, we've come a long way since then. One algorithm that we're going to learn about this season is something called the variational quantum eigensolver, or VQE for short. And this is really important in the field of quantum chemistry. What this does is allow us to simulate the ground state energy of a molecule efficiently. And this is important because classically, this is something that's very difficult to do, because every time you add a particle to the system, the computational cost grows exponentially. However, with a quantum computer, this can be done much more efficiently and can help us discover new medicines and materials in the future. Another algorithm that we'll learn about this season is in the field of quantum machine learning. So we'll take a look at an algorithm called the quantum support vector machine, which will allow us to classify sets of data based off of their features. And this is another very promising quantum algorithm that may have an advantage over its classical counterpart. One of my personal favorite applications has to do with large data sets. So suppose I'm looking for a number in a list of, say, 1,000 elements. If I'm extremely unlucky and my number is at the very end of the list, then classically it'll take me 1,000 tries for me to find my number. However, with a quantum computer, I can get away with only 31 tries, even if my number is at the very end of the list. So how is this even possible? In the following weeks, we're going to really dive into the reasons people are so excited about quantum computing. Even though we're still in the early stages of the field, now is a great time for you to get yourself involved, because for the first time, we can study real-world applications from your living room or anywhere else in the world. Next week, I'll walk you through building your very first quantum algorithm. So be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss out. See you next time.
That was great.
That was
great.
Okay. That
was probably the one.
Okay.
We're gonna record it this time.
Yeah,
all right. Yeah. All right.
Shut up.